So back here with Louisianna Waring from the Vegan Society, and we're going to talk a lot more about veganism. I mean, how do you kind of, your everyday meals, how do you plan it? I mean, how do you kind of, you know, keep the creativity going in the kitchen? How's that
yeah,
work?
Yeah, I mean, do you know, before, I've been vegan 8.5 years. Before that, I hated cooking. I mean, like, I hated it. I couldn't cook, wouldn't cook. I had a shocking diet, which is basically just sugar and caffeine. So since going vegan, you know, it took a bit of time, but it's made me really love food. So I use cookbooks. My partner, he's vegan as well. We cook together. We use recipes online. There's so many YouTube channels as well with really simple recipes. So we've got the basics that we get all the time. So like cottage pie, bolognese, chili, they're like our staples. And then we'll look on YouTube, look online. Yeah, there's so much inspiration out there.
Yeah. Food's getting cheaper, as you know, fruit and vegetables. Is it? Do you find yourself saving money as well?
I think so, yeah. There has been, you know, there is this misconception that veganism is more expensive. If you're buying certain products, it probably will be, you know. The milks, for example, the direct replacements for animal products, they can be more expensive.
Yeah.
But if you're... So there's a couple of things here. If you're going to more towards the whole food diet, you know, like beans, rice, etc., it will 100% be cheaper. And there's research to back that up. But another point to mention is, you know, why is meat so cheap? Why can you get 30 chicken wings for £2? It's not right. It's just, you know, and it's because the industry is subsidised and the vegan industry is not subsidised. You know, we don't want food to be expensive for anyone. We understand that people do live, you know, there's inequality in this country, and veganism, this is why, you know, people can think it's inaccessible, and it shouldn't be to anyone. So we also have a campaign called Live Vegan for Less, which is all about how you can have a healthy vegan diet on a budget. So yeah, we definitely would like it to be even more accessible to everyone, but if you're focusing on those whole foods, then it will be.
Yeah, I mean, what other places encourage veganism then? I mean, there's a lot of different cultures that do that, aren't there? I mean, do you get inspiration from those as well?
Yeah, definitely. And I think, as I say, because you can look at things online,
yeah.
And the internet is an amazing place to find inspiration, because, yeah, you can kind of chat to people from all around the world, or, you know, find different social media profiles from all around the world and, as I say, get inspiration from everyone.
Yeah. What about schools then? I mean, veganism in schools. I mean, do you have a right to a vegan meal in schools nowadays? How's that work? It's been a long time since I went to school, so...
Yeah, so... We actually have two campaigns about this. One is about nursery milk. So it's about including plant milks in nursery milk schemes. And we do have a lot of success with this. As I say, we have legal expertise in the Vegan Society. But it can take a long time. We had a case recently where I think it took a dad over 2 years just to allow the school to purchase oat milk for his child. And it's, you know, incredibly stressful for parents when you're kind of pushing for something which seems so simple. And yes, school meals as well. So as I say, there is a requirement now. Veganism is protected under the equality law. So if you're in school, if you're in hospital, if you're in prison, you have a right to be catered for. And if you are struggling with that, if you're in that situation, you can contact us and we'll help you legally for free.